This video will cover how to merge terrain data for use in a 2D hydraulic model. This process could be completed in any GIS or CAD application, but this video will demonstrate this process using SMS. The example used is for a bridge replacement project. Here, SMS is open, the display projection is set, an image of the project site, and various types of terrain data are loaded. Typical projects require multiple types of data. This project includes LiDAR points with hydro brake lines, channel cross-section points, approximate channel brake lines, and roadway data. Projects may have some variation of data types, but the process of merging them together is the same. Each data set for this project has been imported and converted to scatter data. Different data sets require various levels of editing outside or inside of SMS to get the data ready to merge. It is important to verify the coordinate system and vertical datum of all data sets so they can be merged correctly. The display of scatter data is controlled in the display options. Users can turn on and off the various types of data here. Contours are turned on now. This is the LiDAR data with color-filled contours displayed. The hydro brake lines represent the approximate water surface and water's edge during the LiDAR survey. To see the lines, turn on points and brake lines and turn off contours. Note the inactive data color. This LiDAR dataset has been processed so all points within the hydro brake lines have been classified as water. The LiDAR points shown are classified as ground, so no points appear in the channel. The channel data includes points and brake lines. The channel data has also been edited so all points are within the hydro brake lines. Channel survey data does not exist for the entire model extents, so approximated channel brake lines have been created. These brake lines are also within the hydro brake lines. The roadway data is from a CAD XML file and includes points, brake lines, and triangles based on the XML surface. The roadway data overlaps the LiDAR data. Where the overlap occurs, the roadway data will be used for this project. This video will demonstrate two different ways to merge data sets. First, merge the LiDAR data with the channel data sets. If there's no overlapping areas, datasets can be merged as points and brake lines without triangulation. So the approximate channel, channel points, and hydro brake lines can be merged with the LiDAR data. To do this, select and delete the triangles in the three channel datasets. Once each dataset is ready, they can be merged. The scatter data does not have to be displayed or selected in the main view to be merged. Select Scatter, Merge Sets. In the Merge Scatter Set window, select the LiDAR and channel-related datasets. Name the new merged dataset, leave all other options as default, and hit OK. This process may take a few minutes depending on the size of your data. When completed, a summary report will appear that provides some statistics on the merged surface. Close this window. There is now a new Merge 1 scatter data set. Next, merge this new scatter data set with the roadway data. Select Scatter, Merge Sets. Then select the roadway and Merge 1 data sets. Select Delete lower priority scatter points so the LiDAR data under the roadway data is deleted. In this case, the roadway data overlaps the LiDAR data, which is now in the Merge 1 scatter set. Make sure the higher priority data set is higher in the list than the lower priority data that will be merged. Move data sets up or down if needed, name the new data set, and hit OK. Now that all the data has been merged, the final surface and triangulation should be reviewed. Make sure the merge occurred correctly by comparing the different surfaces. Notice the channel area in the original LiDAR data set. The Merge 1 dataset shows the channel data merged into the LiDAR, so the channel terrain is represented. The Merge 2 dataset shows the roadway data being used adjacent to the bridge crossing. Potential issues to review include vertical differences and triangulation at boundaries of different datasets. Two ways to review the data include viewing and rotating with the filled contours turned on, or creating profiles using observation plots. Rotating the terrain provides a way to visually check the final surface for any oddities or obvious errors. For a more detailed view, observation plots provide a way for closer inspection. An observation coverage is loaded that includes a profile at the roadway crossing. Using the Plot Wizard Observation Profile tool, a plot can be made to view the LiDAR, Merge 1, and Merge 2 surfaces. Here we can see the three surfaces and the difference in the channel area between the LiDAR and Merge 1, and the difference in the abutment area between Merge 1 and Merge 2. The final merge scatter data is now ready to be used in the process of developing a mesh for 2D modeling. A one-page summary sheet outlining key steps of merging terrain data and additional resources is available at this link.